Welcome to Allied Pharma Notes. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about suspensions. Suspensions are the coarse dispersions in which an insoluble solid particle is uniformly distributed in a liquid. Based on the particle size, suspensions are divided into majorly three types. The first one is nano suspensions. The particle size of the nano suspensions is 10 to 200 nanometers. The second type of suspension is deflocculating suspension, and the particle size of the deflocculating suspension is 0.5 to 10 microns. And that type of suspension is flocculating suspension. The particle size of the flocculating suspension is 10 to 50 microns. As already we discussed, that suspensions are the insoluble solids in a liquid. Due to their insoluble, they will undergo the sedimentation. So the sedimentation of the suspensions is explained by the theory of sedimentation. And due to the sedimentation is occurred due to the gravitational force, this is also called gravitational sedimentation. And it was explained by Stokes, that's why it is also called Stokes' law. After sedimentation, you will observe the settling of the particles in a suspension. That's why it is also called settling of the suspensions. According to Stokes' law, the rate of sedimentation is equal to Remember, due to the small particle size, the diameter of the particle won't affect the sedimentation rate, but the square of the particle diameter will affect the sedimentation rate. And the second important thing, the solid particle density and the liquid particle density should be differ. If they are having the same density, then the sedimentation won't occur. That's why you have to take the difference between the solid density as well as the liquid density. Due to sedimentation occur because of the gravitational force, you will have on gravitation also. And one important thing you have to remember, the viscosity influences the 18 times. If you increase viscosity 18 times, the sedimentation volume will be decreases. That's why you have to write 18 into neta. Now, see, rate of sedimentation is equal to d square into rho s minus rho l into g by 18 into neta. But Stokes' law also contains some limitations. For particles which are having spherical in shape, we can easily find the diameter. That's why, according to Stokes' law, the particle size is assumed as a spherical in shape. It it only applicable for the spherical particles only. And second one, the gravitational force only act if the particle size is at least 0.5 microns. So it only applicable for the particles which having the particle size greater than or equal to 0.5 microns. And the third point is, the viscosity influences 18 times, that's why you have to take the diluted solutions, which means the concentration is less than 2%. And remember, the rate of the sedimentation mainly observed in the laminar flow liquids only, which means the Reynolds number is less than 2000. Now here we are going to discuss about briefly related to Reynolds number. Reynolds number is a ratio between the inertial force as well as the viscous force. The inertial force is a forward force which is exhibited by the liquid, whereas the viscous force is a backward force which is experienced by the liquid. If you take the ratios between these two, you will get the Reynolds number. Because of we are taking the ratios between two forces, the units get cancelled, and for the Reynolds number there is no unit will be present. Now we are going to discuss about the what is the application of the Reynolds number. If the Reynolds number is less than 2000, we can say it as a laminar flow. If the Reynolds number is greater than 4000, we can say it as a turbulent flow. But if the Reynolds number is in between 2000 to 4000, we can say it as a critical flow or the transitional flow. In critical or a transition flow, the laminar flow is converted into turbulent flow. Now applications. By using Stokes' law, we can determine the particle size. By using Anderson pipette, by the principle of Stokes' law, we can determine the particle size. Now we are going to discuss about the classification of the suspensions. In that, the first one is deflocculating suspension. The particle size of the deflocculating suspension is 0.5 to 10 microns in size. And the second point is sedimentation rate. Because of the small particle size, the diameter as well as the gravitational force exhibiting on the particle is very less. So according to Stokes' law, the rate of sedimentation mainly directly proportional to the diameter of the particle size as well as the gravitational force act on it. So the sedimentation rate is very slow. Now our question is, what is the nature of the supernet? As I already discussed that the majority of the particles are very small in size, even though the sedimentation occurs, the particles are distributed in a liquid only. Due to the small particles distributed in a liquid, they are observed as a turbid in nature. And the sedimentation type is, because of presence of the small particles, the small particles will fill in the voids between the large particles so that they will form a hard cake. Because of the hard cake formed, if you shake the bottle, the deflocculating suspension won't distribute it uniformly. So the sedimented type is a complex. Now our question is, what is the advantage of the deflocculating suspensions? Because of the small particles, the deflocculating particles having more suspendability. Now our question is, what are the disadvantages of the deep flocculant in suspensions? Because of the small particles, they will form a hard cake. That's why the complex cake formation is the main disadvantage in the deep flocculation suspension. To overcome this problem, we have to add a flocculating agents like electrolytes. So they will form flocules, and flocules are the loosely packed ones, so that if you shake, they will again easily distributed. And what is the rheological behavior of the deflocculating suspensions? At initial state, they are in a salt form. If we apply shear on it, nothing but a mechanical shaking. They will become as a, we can say it as a gel. If you see here, the particles are distributed, but because of the shear force, they became a gel form. Compared to salt, the gel's volume is increased. If you observe here, the gel volume is going to be increases. That's why this is also called dilatant. And the material which exhibits the dilatancy, that materials are called dilatant materials. Here the viscosity of the soil is less compared to the gel. That's why by applying shear, the thickness is going to be increases. That's why this is also called shear thickening materials. And remember, if you stop applying shear stress on the soil, the formed gel won't again become as a soil. That's why the equilibrium state of the dilatant materials is soil. This is very, very important for the GPAT orientation. In shear thickening materials, it only depends on the applied shear stress and it does not depend on the time. That's why it is a time independent phenomena. Now we can see some of the deflocculating suspensions which follow the rheological properties. The first one is the deflocculating suspension which have in the concentration greater than 50. And the second one is zinc oxide suspension having the concentration 30%. And the third one is 12% of choline suspension. Now we are going to discuss about the flocculation suspensions. The particle size of the flocculation suspensions is 10 to 50 microns. And the sedimentation of the flocculation suspensions is fast. Why? Because the particle size is very big. Because of the flocules are readily sedimented, the supernet will be clear. and the type of sedimentation is due to the large particles consist of the voids. That void is filled with the solvent. They can readily redisperse when you give a mechanical shear. That's why the sediment type is loosely packed. The main advantage in the flocculation suspensions is they can readily redisperse. By applying a small shear. The main disadvantage with the flocculation suspension is they having very faster sedimentation rate. To overcome the faster sedimentation of the flocculation suspensions, we have to add the structural vehicles. Examples for the structural vehicles are polymer solutions. These polymer solutions, they will form matrix on the flocules so that the flocule will be uniformly distributed in a suspension. Now, rheological behavior of the flocculation suspensions. At equilibrium state, these flocculation suspensions are present in gel state. After applying shear stress, they will become solids. If you remove the shear stress, then again become as a gels. If these process occur in a two ways, one is in faster manner, another one in a slower manner. If it occur in a slower manner, we can say it as a thixotropy. And the thixotropy is exhibited by polymeric solutions, bentonite and sodium alginate. The materials which follows thixotropy is also called shear thinning materials. Why? Because here the conversion of gel to solid will be occur, which means the viscosity is going to be decreases. That's why this is also called shear thinning materials. And materials which follow thixotropy, they are also called as pseudoplastic materials. Why? Because they will partially follow the plastic flow. And the second case is the conversion of the salt to gel in faster rate. And this phenomena is nothing but the rheophilexy. The best example for the rheophilexic material is bentonite magma clay suspension. Now we are going to discuss about some of the important steps in the formulation of an ideal suspension. The first step in the formulation of the ideal suspension is adding of wetting agent. Because we are adding insoluble particles in a solvent, the particles are not uniformly distributed. So for the uniform distribution, we have to add the wetting agent. Because of presence of wetting agent, the particles are uniformly distributed, and this formulation is nothing but the defrocklating suspension. Example for the wetting agents are surfactants which are having the HLB value 7 to 9. The main disadvantage with the defrocklating suspension is they will form a hard cake. To prevent the formation of the hard cake, we have to add the flocculating agents. Examples for the flocculating agents are electrolytes. Due to adding of electrolytes, they will form flocules. This formulation is nothing but the flocculating suspension. The main disadvantage with the flocculating suspension is they will readily sedimented. To prevent the sedimentation of flocculating suspension, we have to add the structural vehicles. The examples for the structural vehicles are hydrophilic polymers. They will form the matrix between the particles so that uniformly distribution of the flocculus is going to be observed. This formulation is nothing but the ideal suspension. Remember, the ideal suspension formulation consists of wetting agents, flocculating agents, and the structural vehicle. The combination of these three formulation only we can call it as a ideal suspension. The fourth step in the formulation of the ideal suspension is determination of the stability parameters. The first parameter of the stability parameter is sedimentation value. Sedimentation value is defined as the ratio between sedimented volume to the total volume. And for the flocculating suspensions, the sedimentation value is Vu by V0. The second parameter is degree of flocculation. Degree of flocculation is the ratio between the sedimentation value of the flocculated to the sedimented value of the deflocculated suspension. That is, the V0 and V0 get cancelled. We will get Vu by V alpha. The Vu by V alpha for the ideal suspension is 1. And we have to select the suspension which is having the beta value nearly 1. Now we are going to discuss about some of the previously asked GPAT questions on suspensions. The first question is, Reynolds number less than 2000 represents. As already we discussed that the less than 2000 represents as a laminar flow, greater than 4000 represents a turbulent flow, and in between the 2000 to 4000 we can see it as a critical flow or the transition flow. So for the less than 2000, the right answer is laminar flow. Thixotropy was exhibited by deflocculating suspensions, flocculation suspensions, nano suspensions, and emulsions. Among these four, the meaning of the thixotropy is from gel to solid has to convert. In deflocculating suspensions, it will convert from solid to gel. In flocculating suspensions, it will convert from gel to solid. The remaining are the improper answers for the question. Formulation of the ideal suspensions consists of, already I discussed that for the ideal suspensions it should be consist of wetting agent, flocculating agent and a structural vehicle.